guys, this is Vijay and I hope you are doing well. In this video lecture, we will discuss the working principle of vacuum brake. Here you can see that the schematic diagram of a vacuum brake, it consists of master cylinder, control unit, servo cylinder, non-return valve and vacuum reservoir. Okay, we will discuss one by one. Okay, this is a master cylinder. Here you can see that the piston will reciprocate inside the master cylinder, and here the brake fluid is filled. Okay, and here you applied the force on the brake pedal. Okay, this is the brake pedal, and the linkage of the brake pedal, it is connected with the piston, and this piston will reciprocate or slide inside the master cylinder. Okay, it is a braking fluid. Here you can see that it is a another piston. Okay, this piston is reciprocate in the control unit. Here you can see that the rod of the piston, it is connected with the two other valves. Okay, and the function of the control unit, okay, it will allow the air, or it will allow the contact of the atmosphere with the servo cylinder. Okay, here you can see that in a servo cylinder, the piston, it is connected, one side it is connected with the control unit, and another side here you can see that it is connected with the brake system. Okay, so from where, so here you can see that this shaft is connected with the braking system. Okay, to operate the braking system, this is a vacuum reservoir, and this vacuum reservoir, it is connected with the inlet of the manifold through non-return valve. Okay, as we know that, okay, vacuum means the pressure below atmospheric pressure, it is called vacuum, it is a negative pressure. So let's start its working. How can it work? As we know that, what is the function of brake? Okay, the function of the brake is to stop the vehicle in emergency and whenever it is required, or to slow down the speed of the vehicle. So at that time we applied the force on the brake pedal. Okay, and this brake pedal, it is connected with the linkage through the piston. Okay, and this piston will pressurize the fluid. Okay, as we know that the Pascal law, okay, the intensity of pressure is equally transmitted in all the directions. Okay, in fluid mechanics subject, okay, we have already derived the equation, and we prove that Px equal to Py equal to Pz, the intensity of pressure, it is equally transmitted in all the direction. So whenever we applied the force on the brake pedal, at that time this piston will pressurize the braking fluid, and this braking fluid, it will operate the piston. Okay, this piston will slide or reciprocate inside the control unit cylinder. Okay, and here you can see that the rod of the piston, it will operate the two other valves. Okay, here you can see that this top valve, it is connected with the atmosphere. Okay, and it is connected with the spring. Okay, so whenever we applied the force through the brake pedal, at that time this piston will pressurize the braking fluid, and this braking fluid will operate the piston, and this piston will open this valve. Okay, and at that time we are doing the work against the spring. Whenever the valve will move upward direction, at that time there is a direct contact of atmosphere with the left hand side of the servo cylinder. So here you can see that on left hand side of the servo cylinder, it is a positive pressure, because whenever we operate this pedal, at that time this piston will pressurize the braking fluid, and this braking fluid will operate the piston, and this piston is connected with the two other valves. At that time this valve will open, and it will allow the air, or there is a physical contact, there is a direct contact of atmosphere with the left hand side of the servo cylinder. Here you can see that on right hand side of the servo cylinder, there is a connection with the vacuum reservoir. Okay, in this vacuum reservoir, always the vacuum will be maintained. We know that vacuum means the negative pressure, pressure below atmospheric pressure, and this vacuum will be maintained through the non-return valve, means it is connected with the inlet manifold. As we know that inlet manifold means it is the piping distribution system, and these pipes are connected with the suction line, means it is connected with the inlet of the engine. Okay, and it is directly connected with the right hand side of the servo cylinder. So here you can see that on right hand side of the servo cylinder, always negative pressure will be there, and whenever we operate the brake pedal, at that time this braking fluid will operate the piston, and piston will operate the top valve. Okay, so this top valve, whenever it will open, so at that time there is a contact of air or atmosphere with the left hand side of the cylinder. So here the positive pressure will be there, and here the negative pressure will be there, and we know that energy is always flow from high grade to low grade. So at that time the piston will move from left hand side to right hand side, and this movement is utilized to apply the brake. Okay, so it will operate the working principle of vacuum, so it is called vacuum brake. I hope this content, it will be helpful to you to understand the working principle of vacuum brake. Thank you friends for watching this video.